If you like to use your iPad for reading sheet music, I've got a tip for you that's going to make your practicing even more fun and effective. It's Anne here from Music Discoveries, and I know that many of you like to use your iPad to save and organize your digital sheet music. Personally, I use an app called ForScore. I've been using that app for, gosh, close to 10 years now, I imagine. There are other apps that you can use too. But what I want to show you in today's video is how you can watch a YouTube video and watch your digital sheet music at the same time on the same screen. So we need to learn how to multitask. So in this video, I'll be using the second generation iPad Pro, version 15.1, and I'll be using ForScore, version 13.0.4. So let's say that I'm practicing Scarborough Fair. I've already found the video on YouTube, so that's ready to go, and I've found the sheet music in ForScore, but I want to be able to watch both of those elements at the same time. So we need to multitask, and I'll show you how to do that. Just go up to the top of the screen and look for the three dots. Tap on the three dots, and that will open up a little box for you. Now click on the middle icon, that's the split screen icon, and the iPad will prompt you to choose your second window. That's going to be the YouTube video, right? So now you see how the sheet music is on the left and the video is on the right. So you can watch your video and scroll through the sheet music at the same time. Isn't that handy? So if you like that hint, please let me know by giving the video a like. You can let me know in the comments if you're going to try that new little trick. Now, to be totally honest, I had a second tip for you. I was going to show you how you can embed an MP3 in your ForScore sheet music so that you can listen to an audio file and play the music at the same time. And that was going really, really well all week. I was testing that whole workflow. And as I was shooting the video, this video today, just a few minutes ago, a pop-up came up from ForScore, here it is right here, that says that feature is causing crashes on the iPad. And it's an unresolved issue right now. So I guess I'm not going to be recommending that feature at all. And it made me think maybe what I should do is create another short video of suggested best practices for keeping your digital sheet music safe. Let me know what you think about that in the comments. And when I make that video, I will put it right over here for you to watch next.